Welcome to Woggle Guides. If you're moving from Outlook to Gmail and you're worried that you're going to lose some of those features that you like in Outlook, then this guide could be for you. In this guide, we're going to take a look at how to set up Gmail with some of the more common Outlook features, which aren't usually available by default when you set up Gmail. Let's get straight into it. And remember, you can jump straight to your particular area of interest by clicking on the sections below. The first Outlook feature we're going to create in Gmail is displaying new emails separately in the inbox, as opposed to the conversation view used by default in Gmail. Let's start by explaining the difference between the Outlook single message view and Gmail's conversation view. The conversation view used by Gmail takes related messages, usually identified by subject, and groups them together. Only one message is ever shown in the inbox, regardless of how many messages are shared on a message thread. And if a new message is received, the message group will appear unread at the top of the inbox. This is very different to how Outlook handles groups of related messages. In Outlook, each message is treated and shown individually. Messages are not grouped, and each new message received appears separately in the inbox. Let's now turn to Gmail and see how we can recreate this view. So we're logged into Gmail, and as you can see, at the top of the inbox there is a threaded conversation with multiple emails on it. We'll revisit this conversation once we've switched from the conversation view, just to see how it's displayed. To change the conversation view, we'll start by clicking on the cog icon to access settings. If we scroll down in this menu, you'll see that email threading is shown at the very bottom. To turn off the conversation view, we simply uncheck the checkbox. Gmail then pops up a message confirming that Gmail will be reloaded in order to reset the inbox threading view. Let's choose that. And if we take a look at the inbox now, you'll see that that threaded conversation I referenced earlier is now split out into discrete individual messages in your inbox. Note that if you turn off the conversation view on any of your devices, then the change will be replicated across all of your devices. So that includes both desktop and mobile. So now we're going to look at how to set up an Outlook reading pane in Gmail. By default, Outlook displays a reading pane view to the right of the email list in the inbox. In comparison, Gmail does not offer a preview pane by default. The default view setting in Gmail is a no split, where, as you can see in this inbox view, only a summary of the emails is shown. In order to view the email details, you need to click on the email and open it up. So let's look at how to set up a preview pane so that it looks just like the Outlook view. To do that, as before, we need to click on the gear icon to open up Quick Settings. We'll stay in the Quick Setting menu, but we'll scroll down to the Reading Pane section. The equivalent of the default Outlook view is right of inbox from those options shown. Let's choose that. And returning to the inbox, you can see that the right side of the inbox is now taken up with a preview of an email when you click on it. And the options on the right of the preview pane also allow you to reply or forward on that email directly within the preview window. So now we're going to look at how to recreate the calendar and task view that's shown in the Outlook inbox. Another common feature in Outlook is the calendar and task view shown in the right-hand panel. As you can see, both the calendar and task management features are integrated within Outlook. If we turn to Gmail, both calendar and task features are available, but it's not initially obvious how to activate them. They can be found, similar to Outlook, in the right-hand panel. Let's look at each in turn. We can access the calendar by clicking on the calendar icon. This opens the panel with a Google Calendar view. Google Calendar will automatically add any events or meetings that go into your inbox. Events can also be added directly to the calendar in this view. To access Google Tasks, we click on the Tasks icon. Here you'll see that tasks can also be added directly, or emails can be added as tasks for later review. Now we're going to take a look at the differences between how Outlook manages emails in folders and Gmail uses labels to achieve the same thing, and how it does it a little bit better. So looking at Outlook, you'll see folders are a key part of the menu system and used to store and manage emails. Gmail uses labels to do the same things, and they function almost exactly the same as folders, but with one important difference. Whilst in other email tools, such as Outlook, emails can only be moved to a single folder, in Gmail, emails can be assigned to multiple labels. So when using Gmail for labels, just think folders. So how do we set up labels or folders in Gmail? Well, to add a new label, navigate to the left-hand menu and scroll down to the bottom, and you'll see an option to create new label. If we click on that, you're prompted to give the new label a name. Let's call this one Test Folder. Now if we click into an email and I choose the labels icon on the top bar, you'll see I can choose to add the email to that label or folder directly. In the same way, I can also click on the email and drag it to a label in the left-hand menu, just like an Outlook. One last thing to show you about labels is the Manage Labels feature in Gmail. We can find that by navigating to the Manage Labels setting in the left-hand navigation bar. And if we click into that, you'll see a list of both the standard Gmail folders as well as any new ones that you may have created. In this section, label names can be edited or labels deleted. Note that deleting a label will not remove any of the emails associated with that label. Only the label will be removed. I do hope you've found this Woggle guide useful. If you have, please subscribe so that other users can find it too. And if you have any questions on using Gmail, please share in the comment section down below. Look after yourself until next time.